guys, this is my first video tutorial and today I'm gonna show you how to import images in Lightroom and color correct them. So let's begin. I'm using Adobe Lightroom Creative Cloud version, and as you can see, once it opens, it delivers the Lightroom module, and towards the left of the screen you can see folders, and this is where we import the images folder wise. So what we're gonna do is, towards the left bottom you can see an import button, so you click it and new window appears. So you can see this, you have to select a source to select the image from. So what I've done is, I used to save my images in a date wise order, so I've already selected few images for this tutorial. So let's just click on that date, and yeah, few images appear, so it's already been selected. So I just have to click import towards the right bottom corner. So I just press import, and you can see on top just fetching initial previews and done. So now what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna go to the develop module. You just click develop, or you can press D on the keyboard. So as you can see, the images come in the raw format. I usually take in raw because it gives me the flexibility to work with the image. So what I'm gonna show you right now is the before of this image and after. So you can see right now, this is what I worked it to be, and this is the raw image. So now I'll show you how to get that detail into the image. It's very basic and it's very easy. Okay, so what we're gonna do first is look for the white balance. So I want it a little cooler, so I just take the temperature. So if you can go, this is the limits, so we don't want that vibrant ones. You just go for a little cooler tone, and that's almost it. And next is exposure. You have to bring it down a little, because I think I took this image at 1/10 of a second. That's a shutter speed, and f22 is aperture, because I needed to get those milky waterfalls. So next is contrast. So you have to get those high details in the image. So contrast will bring you that. And next is highlights. Since this is a little overexposed, this waterfalls, what I'm gonna do is bring down the highlights a bit. So you can see, as we go down, you more details appear on the faults, mostly towards the overexposed area of the image. And the opposite goes for shadows. As we bring it up, the underexposed area of the image gets more detail and lights up. And whites also perform in a similar way, but it's more control over the light as whole. So if you need that little bright, and the blacks similarly as opposite to the whites, we can see how we can tweak it. And for this image, I think I'll just put it down so that detail on the rocks remain there. And next is clarity. Since you want to make this a very natural image, you can bring a little bit clarity to this thing, and the rocks now have a lot of details on them. And next is the vibrance. Obviously, once you bring it up, you know what it shows. Same way, the saturation. And you should note that saturation works mostly for landscapes. You have to go high on that. When it's people or something else, you have to be a little careful of not over saturating the image. But for a landscape or this thing, I think saturation can go a bit little high. So this is basically the first part of color correcting an image. So you can see before and after, and the shortcut key for seeing that is Y. If you press Y, you can see before and after of the image. It's pretty cool to go back to where you started from. It's a very nice way to have a track of your work. Okay, what we're gonna do next is play with the tone curve. The same way you see the highlights, it's this curve. So I'm not gonna go in detail into it. You just have to tweak the lights and the darks the same way, which makes compelling for you There are a lot of ways you can do it. So this is my way of doing it. And it changes from image to image. And next thing is what I'm gonna show you how to affect the colors in the image. So you have this independent way of selecting a particular color and, you know, its hue, its saturation and its luminance. So for a trial, I'm gonna show you the orange. So you can see the oranges can be affected in this way, and the saturation of the orange can too be affected. So I think for this image, I think I'll bring up a little more of a saturation for the orange. And the luminance, obviously, you can see what is happening here. And the same goes for each and every color we have in this. So the yellows as well. So have to look what you have made the difference is before and after is there's a toggle here. So if you can press on that, you can see the changes you have made in that particular module. So you can see how it is. This is my minor difference. So that's all we need for this image. And as we go down, there's split toning, which I'm not gonna touch for this image. And next is detail. So it's sharpening. I usually keep it around 80, 70 range, which should do good. And if you have an image that has a lot of noise, this is one way of reducing it, is noise reduction. So you just press a little here. The problem with too much of noise reduction is you lose detail. The images get a little less sharpened, so you don't have to go too much on that. And the last one I do for this image is the lens correction, because all lenses come with a sort of distortion. So enable, and the Lightroom automatically detects it, that I've used a Canon camera, a 2470 lens. So it has a profile already set for it. All cameras details are already stored here. So you can see that here. All right, and all the lenses. So you can do that. So what it takes out the vignetting of the image and a center distortion. You can see right now. So what I'm gonna do is, towards the last effect, I'm gonna bring a little vignetting to the image, so to make the center of the image more interesting. And post crop vignetting is what shows that even if you crop the image, the vignetting remains same. So you have to play with it further. That's totally up to you. You can really go in deep or something like this. So I just want a little this thing. So you can again see before and after of your vignetting alone. And that is almost it, I guess. So I think we'll again reduce a little more brightness over it, and I think the highlight should go down a little. Yeah, so that is almost it. This is basically how you color correct an image. So this is the before and this is the after. And note that this can mostly be done on raw images, because raw images have the flexibility over JPEGs, so you can be limited while using JPEG images. So as I would suggest, raw images are heavy in size, but you have a lot more freedom in post-processing. So that's it, guys. Thank you for watching this video. Tune in for more. I'll be updating with more videos soon.